Everybody, it's the Victa. It's time to continue eating streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for making the Devil Deal this week possible. I am super happy with the way that it ended, of course. We did get kind of lucky, I will say, on at least 5 of the 7 runs. I wouldn't say all of them, but that is also related to your meme of the day brought to you by Equinox Games. Invicta, you cannot deny the existence of Invicta luck. Also, Invicta got some pretty, let's just call it what it is. We did get lucky with that week, but maybe that luck runs out. Who really knows? But again, thank you all for making it possible. Seed Day is going to be 1 Quebec Romeo, 0 Victor Whiskey, Sierra Quebec. We've got great damage to start off with, good tiers rate, terrible shot speed, and even worse movement speed. Also have the shovel and death list, and a temperance card. Yeah. So if we start balling out of control here, maybe I'll have a troll, a trolling possibility anyway. Excuse me. Thank you. You know, you guys and gals know me. You know that I'm not above trolling people. I'm not saying I'm going to do that here. I'm just saying if we get something like, you know, Ipecac or Magic Mush, something soon, something early, I'm definitely going to be, you know, doing it. We can get Leprosy, I suppose, especially with those hearts there. The only reason why I hesitated was not because I'm worried about dying, but because I'm trying to think ahead about this Temperance card. Excuse me. Thank you. The red champion fly was like taking a trajectory that was like breaking my brain. So that white skull that you see above the you don't see anymore, but it was above that champion, is death list. And if we kill the enemies based on that, on death list's order, we gain a fairly impressive amount of possible stats. Gonna go ahead and separate these two as well. Just because we're looking for a nice, safe place to be. There we go. Got the soul heart. I'm actually not going to take that soul heart right now. Although I probably should, because I might forget where it is. Yeah, so there we go. And we got a soul heart from there as well. Cool. So yeah, so Death's List paid out with a soul heart there. It's an excellent item that you can find in Devil Deals. It does allow you to... It doesn't break the tiers cap. But it can break the soft cap if you have had another item that already breaks it. It's excellent. But, I mean, you can get any and every stat that's possible you can get with Death's List. Trying to thread the needle here. There we go. That was going to be the toughest one. He's done it. Bet you didn't think I was going to be able to do that. We got a 2 tiers upgrade. And an Emperor card as well. That's some big-time plays right there, son. The Leprosy is going to give us a couple of orbitals here. It's not really about the money at this point for the Temperance Machine, because obviously I want the Emperor card. Trying very, very hard. No, it's not going to happen. So what's the golden rule about Death List? Don't prioritize it over getting hit. It's never worth taking damage for Death List, ever. Ever. There's no good excuse for you to take damage if you're trying to go for Death's List. If you can make it happen, if you think that you can control the room, fine. But if it comes down to it, when it's all out on the table and it's either you're going to possibly take a hit, or, you know, or you might get a payout from Death's List, always just clear the room. It's never worth it. But we got a nice little 2 tiers upgrade there, and you can get that in just you can get damage as well. That's the nice thing about Death's List. You can get damage out of it, and it saved quite a few runs in our time. In our time, Death's List saved us quite a lot. Thank you, Leprosy. Look at that. We get a shot speed upgrade and even more shot speed and damage. Oh man. It does feel quite right being able to take Devil Deals again, though. I was missing it. I really was. It was killing me not to know what that item was on yesterday's episode, the 2 heart item, because we really could have used it. Obviously, I mean, assuming it was anything good. You know, you can't have bad 2 heart Devil Deals. And a lot of people on the previous episode were also naming all the other items that I forgot that don't have cooldowns. Like I pretty much knew they would. When I'm put on the spot like that, my brain just kind of like locks up, you know? Because I'm like, I gotta make this entertaining. That's my fake boomer brain talking. I do love that anytime Krendor does something like stupid or like really like have slow reaction time in League of Legends, though, he calls it his boomer fingers. That boomer APM. I do like that. So we got a charge key and two bombs out of that. You might be wondering why I'm still using the... Oh, man. Humbling Bundle would be great. Why am I still using the shovel on every cooldown? It's because it has the possibility of paying out with a crawl space. So I'm looking for any opportunity to use the shovel. But like I said, if we get something really crazy out of control... I guess you could tell by the length of this episode whether or not we trolled or not. Holding poop over there. I'm going to have to use two bombs to get to this tinted rock. That's fine. And there's the crawl space. That's the reason why we weren't spawning one. I'm not going to pick up those yet because this might be the counterfeit penny, which it's not. If you ever have a golden poop and you have the option to wait on picking up money in the room, definitely pop the golden poop first in case if you get the counterfeit penny, because you might be robbing yourself out of a lot of potential lost income there. Of course, this is going to be enough for us to get Humbling Bundle, so we're off to the races and off to a very good start. Off to a very good start. Now, the real question is, how are we going to be feeling after our first Devil Deal? Are we going to get a premier carry item? Are we going to get one of my favorite carry items? Are we going to get Guppy? Man, wouldn't that be cool if we got Guppy in one Devil Deal? The whole world's our oyster, Isaac, and we're all ready to take a sip or something. Fortunately, leprosy broke as soon as I touched Dangle. I am going to use a bomb. Oh, you jerk. Oh, we still got the damage anyway. There we go. The placenta, which is not great. And we get Void, which is also not great. I mean, it's great, but it's not what I wanted. We got a shot speed upgrade there. I could copy the shovel. I'm not going to. Because I want to use Void to void Peep's Eye. But because we took a deal with the devil, means that we have a deal with the devil precedent. Thought I was going to sneeze for a moment there. And we got another Tears Up. And another shot speed upgrade. Wow. So we went from having, like, depressingly low shot speed to, oh my goodness, we're starting to get, like, we're almost at 2. Like, that's insane. That is a lot of shot speed, man. And Curse of the XL again. I think this is the third... This is the third run in a row now that we've had Curse of the XL, Curse of the Labyrinth, on the third floor. It's almost enough to make me rage and just use the Emperor card, but I'm not going to because we really need the items. And the death list clears, of course, but I'm not happy about this. GeoGuessr, of course, will be back today, starting today. A soul heart there. Thank you very much. That's going to pay for our entrance into the cursed room. Which might give us something else. And we got a damage upgrade of 1. I'm telling you, death list is incredible. We got a flat damage upgrade there just from killing enemies in a specific order. That's amazing. Wow, the shot speed is real nice. Got a nickel from Death List there. It's the best item that you never knew you wanted. Now, of course, it is very easy to void the benefits of Death's List by simply, you know, AoE, or if you're just inaccurate with shots or that sort of thing. But what I will say, got a movement speed upgrade from that. What I will say is what you should always do, if you get Death's List and you already have yourself a good run like this run, it's a perfect time to practice your accuracy. Like in that fly room that I had on floor one. It's a really good opportunity for you to take advantage of a gift and just practice your accuracy. Try to hit it in order, but don't do it if it means you're putting yourself in harm's way. It's never worth it. And with Void here, you know what? I'm gonna avoid that. We got another damage up. Awesome. It's not that I don't like Luckfoot, of course, but I don't care about luck at this point. I'm looking for raw stats. We're already at the tiers cap. We have 7.40 damage now. Most of that was granted to us by Death List or Void. And the added combined power of Void and Death List is going to prove to be huge, stats-wise. I mean, we have the potential here to get really out of control. Remember, every time that we're getting... any time that Death List is paying out or Void is paying out, we are getting... We're getting stats at the base level. So everything that hinges around Isaac's base damage, movement speed, shot speed, tears rate, blah, 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 all that stuff is being positively impacted by Death's List and Void. Which means this early on especially, that means that we might get out of control soon. Potentially one of the more powerful runs that we could ever have or hope for. Yes, these do count as Death's List, by the way. That nickel that you saw pop up right there, that was from Death's List. One key for two bombs. And by that, I mean one bomb for two keys. Pretty good deal. There's a 0% chance we make it happen here. I can tell you that right now, brother. We're just looking to not get hit. Lots of full charges here. This room is a little bit difficult to try to get the Death List order in. Sometimes you can do it, sometimes you can't. It really just kind of depends on where they shoot first. That wasn't Death List, that was a regular Tendon Rock paying out with double Soul Heart. And yeah, we're still just looking for that other item room. Again, this room does count as a clear for Death List. That's where that Soul Heart came from. I'm not even going to attempt it with this room here. But yeah, man, thanks for making the Angel Devil deal this week happening. It honestly was great to test yourself to figure out, like, man, we really cannot take this Devil deal that I really, really desperately want. And for all the ways that we ended up, I mean, again, we got lucky. We got insanely lucky with a lot of the runs. You know, we've seen items that we don't normally see. Yeah, I'll take Mysterious Liquid. Mysterious Liquid's not terrible here, especially when our base damage is just going to continue to climb. Endor's Box is going to give us Chemical Peel. I'm also going to buy Jar of Flies. Only reason why I'm doing this, though, is because I want to have the power to do that with Void. And I'm gonna Void Chemical Peel. We got another damage and another luck upgrade. This is good. It's real good. Now people were asking about the cashless week, and I've been doing more thinking about the prerequisites and whatnot, and I'm still convinced that it should be okay for me to donate, and it should be okay for me to use a credit card or to use store credit. But outside of those instances, there's no I will not be spending any money in any of those runs. Even if the streak seems like it's on the line, I cannot think of a scenario that may put me in a position to where like one penny can make or break the streak. Blue cap. I actually probably shouldn't have done that because we were capped at the tiers rate. We just lowered our shot speed a little bit. You know? Sometimes you just get fed up. Sometimes you just get fed. So I'm still continuing my week long period of having no sleep. Maybe honestly, I started sleeping poorly even by my standards when we started doing Angel Week or the Devil Dealers Week. So maybe I like actually needed like Stanley to help me out. Maybe that's what's been keeping me up at night. I'm not entirely sure. Would be Krampus, wouldn't it? Would be Krampus. I am going to take a lump of coals. Too good not to have. Vercano. And I will go take a little gander at what's going on. We got the D-Wizzle. We got the Celtic Krizzle. Built Mizzle and Sister Mizzle. Three in a row.
Welcome back to Devil Deals, nerd. Enjoy your 3XLs, loser.
Three Curse of the XLs in a row, huh? I guess we are true. We are back on form. We are back to being, you know, the universe has been corrected, stars have been realigned, and the galaxy can now resume its mundane job of just trolling the ever living hell out of me every single run. And honestly, whatever, you know, it's like whatever. The game has to do this kind of thing to have a chance against us at this point. Something short of like starting us with like just the worst possible start of all time. It will only be able to cheat to beat us. I guess I probably don't need a bomb out of here. Oh, that deals damage now. Okay. Barring the worst like stat start of all time, the game is going to have to either cheat to kill us, or it's going to have to do something like give us no items at all ever and then just ruin our day. It would ruin the whole year. Now I don't know what happens when the streak ends. It's going to end. It may be today. Unlikely, but it's possible. You never know, man. You just never know with this game. This does count as a death list clear, by the way. I'm happy to get more bombs. It allows me just to nope on out of rooms I don't feel like being in. Kind of like this room. A spectral host hat over there. And kind of like this room as well. I don't mess with the popcorn hives anymore. Those guys can, the walking hives can just I don't mind the walking hives. What I do mind, however, that was a tiers upgrade that we didn't see because we're already at the cap, by the way. If you're wondering what stat we got there. It's not the walking hives that I have the problem with. It's the death rattle mobs that spawn after you destroy them. Those are the ones that I have a problem with, and I think that are designed just to be a giant middle finger to the player. And as someone who plays this game, I'm not a fan of anything like that. As someone who plays this thing, whenever this thing wrongs me, I don't like that. Expert level color commentary brought to you by Sinvicta, your favorite neighborhood nerd. We got Mama Gertie. Thank you everyone for wishing my mother happy birthday. She got a tear in her eye when I told her that she had thousands of people tell her happy birthday. And we had a very nice dinner. It was overall just a good night. Then I came home thinking, man, I can't wait to start playing Isaac so I can take devil deals again. Oh, you sweet summer child. If I had only known. Funny how after we fight Mom's heart, we now have to fight Fistula. No deal with the devil, 68%. LOL. Wow, no curse the XL. Amazing. Sinvicta, it's not possible you curse the XL in the cathedral, Sinvicta. Yeah, I know. That was a joke. See? We got one devil deal. One. At least I'm pretty sure it was only one. Our only devil deal we got was Void. And then we got three curse of the XL. That is quite incredible. And for those of you who don't know why, I absolutely despise Crystal Labyrinth. Just watch yesterday's episode. I pretty much explained it right there. Mom's Pearl. Take over the Louse. I'm not going to go... At this point, there's no reason for us to go anywhere except just to try to end the run. And it's not been a bad run either, is the thing. It's just been bad. It's not been a bad run. It's just been bad. Because of the triple curse the XL that night, I purposely skipped two floors worth of items because it's out of rage. Like, I was already, like, thinking about doing it on the first curse the XL repeat, but the second one, like, I'm not going to let the game win one over on us like that. And, yeah. Here we are in the cathedral, just going in the wrong way, you know, doing as we do. And rock that I did not see until now. More bombs, more keys, and another dead end. All right, there we go. So we have gone in all the wrong directions, everyone. Congrats, we made it, I know. I am just going to do my civic duty and just leave this run now. Would have been nice if we'd gotten, like, a soul heart generator. I'm hoping that we get something in the chest. Soul heart, thank you very much. Take a luck upgrade here. 5.73 luck now. Pretty good. I could do the dark chests, but I could also not do the dark chests. And honestly, if the game's gonna be this trolly for the floor generators, then you know what? I'm not gonna play into its hands. It's what it wants us to do. I know your plan, game. Wow, 10 damage now. Keep in mind that like 6 of this damage was given to us by Void. That is quite remarkable. Unfortunately, Leprosy is completely useless against Isaac, as you just saw right there. Any of the orbitals that you spawn from taking damage will immediately be consumed by Isaac's automatic shots. I'm also just now realizing that our movement speed isn't quite up to snuff. Mysterious Liquid doing some work. I wouldn't mind getting Holy Light, to be honest. I could go back and go grab that full charge for Void, so we could void anything in the chest immediately, but I'm not going to do that because we've already skipped quite a few rooms to get here. And if we get good items here anyway, then it's not going to matter. LOL. And what would those good items be? Well, we're about to find out. Mom's Pad, Pheromonal Treatment, Deck 2, and Holy Mantle. One of these items is not like the others. I'll give you a hint. It's the only one that we took. What's the difference between that and the other three, you say? Well, this one's actually good and should exist in the game. There you go. Boom. Drop the mic. Yes, Husky. Hello. What can I do for you, Husky? Let's all read this text message together. He sent me 5 thumbs up emojis. Thank you, Husky. Not exactly sure what he's thumbs upping about, but I'm going to assume that he had a good workout or something. Get another luck upgrade, courtesy of Death's List. I mean, Death's List is the true all-star here. Death's List made this run happen because remember way back when, 26 minutes ago, when we had like decent tier. I mean, I think we started with an eight tier delay, and then we got another tiers up, all the way down to the tiers cap of 5. That's a very weird sentence to say, especially if you type it out and read it. Yeah, we don't want Mr. Boom. We don't really care about Mr. Boom. Okay, we're just going to do this room again for the third time. Things certainly come in threes today. I feel like that's the running theme we've got going here. More like the running threem. Thank you. Thank you, Wrath. Oh, okay. We're just going to do this room again for the fourth time. That's neat. Eventually, I think there's other rooms that exist in this game. I've seen this game played on YouTube once or twice before. I seem to recall there being more than just one type of encounter in this chest. I could be wrong about that. I only have 50 hours in the game. All right, there we go. So there's the west and northern part of this. You know what? Sure. We get 2 damage out of that, which is way better than what Experimental Treatment would have given us. It's the stat tandem. The duo of Void and Death List is quite good. It can make up for a lot of lost stats, especially if you do what I do and skip 2 entire floors out of pure shock and rage and comedic value. So the Holy Mantle is... But the Holy Mantle is going to shield us from taking one hit of damage per room. Unless you have the cage, who will roll into you as soon as they get a chance to. Unfortunately, Super Sloth ruined our death list in here, and that's okay. I'm not going to be greedy with the damage, even though I kind of want to. Skinny on Mushroom, both of these are a terrible... Well, one of these is terrible. It was a terrible idea. The other one's not so much terrible. Just that we don't need poison bombs. I'm not going to take Skinny on Mushroom, however, though. That is exclusively a damage down, and for no gain. We're already tiers capped. Obviously. We had seafood tonight for dinner, and it was great. I don't get a chance to eat a lot of seafood anymore outside of, like, you know, tuna sandwiches from Subway. But I mean, can you really call that seafood? It's not seafood, right? I mean, yeah, I know tuna is made, like, in the sea. That's right, they make tuna in the sea. I mean, I guess truer words were never spoken, but still. You understand the awkwardness of that phrase. Anyway. Calling tuna sandwiches... What'd you have for lunch today? Oh, I had seafood. Oh, really? What'd you have? I had a tuna sandwich from Subway. I'm gonna look at you strange if you say that to me. And you're not joking. Or meaning it in some sort of ironic quip way. You know what I mean? So I don't really count that as seafood. As far as, like, bona fide seafood, I just ate some fish off the bone sort of thing. Man, I do not recall. Oh, hey, speaking of holy light, there we go. I cannot recall the last time I had actual, like, seafood. So I was really stoked tonight for Mom's birthday because I wanted to eat some mahi. In Bermuda, it's the mahi-mahi, which is the Hawaiian word. For this fish. Most people know it as mahi. We knew it in Bermuda as wahoo. And if you've never seen these fish, they're ginormous. They're like blown up. Another dead end, by the way. All right. There's the west, north, and south directions. Everyone, we did it. Let's go to the east now. He's done it. But... essentially, just think of like a giant, I would say almost mackerel, kind of, and pack like 50, 60 pounds of just of muscle behind that. That's what a wahoo is or mahi is. Like a kingfish, except much bigger than a kingfish. For those of you who are deep sea fishers out there, you know what I'm talking about. I love deep sea fishing. Although I can never do it now, I would like immediately get seasick and probably be miserable for the entire day. I never used to get seasick, but that's for another trip. That's for another Isaac episode. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that one. Hey, look at that. We have Devil Deal. Eel is back. The one Devil Deal is back on the streak. What a weird run. What a fun one. Thank you, Death List, and thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. I'll see you next time.